Hey everyone, Daniel here from Twin Bytes with another tutorial here for you, and this time on how to block porn and phishing sites. There's been a few options out there for a while now, and I'm going to cover a couple of them here and show you in detail about the one that I prefer. Now there's the Microsoft Family Filter, which you can go onto their website, and I'll have the links below in the comments, or in the more info. And you can go in there, basically download the software, put that on your computer. You can turn on the web filtering for that particular user, for that particular computer. And from the checklist here, you can choose what's the best suited level of filtering for that person. So if it's just a very young child that's getting started, you can put it on the lowest level. If you're getting into teenagers, high school and that, they need to do research, they need more access for certain things, you can increase the level. OpenDNS also has something similar, and it's been said that you don't need software, but really you do. As you can see in the details below, it's if you go into the settings once you create the account, you'll see that it says if you have dynamic IP address, you will need to use the software so it can keep it up to date and it will continue to work. If you don't know the difference between static and dynamic IP addresses, I've made a video on that as well. But you can also... So, another option is based on the computer itself. I'm going to show you here using Windows 7 and the latest version of Internet Explorer 8. Go over to Tools. Whoops, Tools. If I can click on it and go to Internet Options, and we want the Content tab. Now, ignore the parental controls up on the top. That's for something else that we can get into on another video. You want to go into your Content Advisor. So, two things here. One is we're going to enable it, and we're going to change the settings. So when we go to enable it, it's going to go into the options, but I've already set this up, so it's already asking me for my password to turn it on. So I'm going to have to go into settings specifically and put in my password. So when you enable it for the first time, you can just hit enable and it'll take you right in here. And all we're going to do is go through each one of these options, changing the slider bar, and that's pretty much it. So for each option here, you can go from no filtering to limited filtering to unrestricted filtering. Now I said no filtering, really that means none. The filtering would be that it's not going to allow any of this particular content. So when it comes to any content that creates fear, intimidation, etc., none of it is allowed. You can say the limited, so some stuff will be allowed, but only in an artistic, medical, educational, sports, or news context. And then you've got unrestricted, where it will show everything. So depending on what the category is, if the child is doing research on a particular category and they need to get some more information on that, you'll want to have it set to none. You'll have to allow it to limited, which you'll see for each one of these things, gives the option of restricted, as long as it's in the sense of artistic, medical, educational, and so on. Once you have all the options set to where you want, you just hit OK, and when you OK again, it'll prompt you to create your password. I've already put my password in, so it's not prompting me here. So if the child's smart enough to even know to go into the Internet Options and go to the Content tab, they'll say, oh, well, I'm just going to disable this. Yep, let's disable it. Oh, there's a password, so they're not going to be able to do it. Unless they know what the password is, they're not going to be able to disable that. But, of course, you'll know the password, so you can do that. Now, you can also go in here and set up other options and have your password hint and so on. The supervisor can type a password to allow users to view restricted content, so they can always call you and say, hey, can you let me get access to this particular website, and then you'll be able to allow that by just typing your password right there on the spot. You can also add approved websites to the list, and it'll automatically allow those websites as exceptions. Okay, that's it for this tutorial. Thanks a lot, and don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe if you haven't. And until next time, all right, thanks. Bye for now.